Good morning. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to Forest Presbyterian Church. We're living God's heart, hands, and voice. If you are watching us on Facebook or YouTube this morning, we welcome you there as well. We welcome everyone in the name of Jesus Christ, especially to the family of those who are singing for us today, the Jefferson Forest Advanced Choir. We are glad that you are here under the direction of our own DaShay Glover. And if you are family members of theirs, we welcome you as well. We are so glad to have y'all again and welcome you this morning. We have a few announcements for the life of our church this morning. Laura, you want to start?
Good morning. I'm Laura Collier from Missions. I want to say thank you for those who took an angel tree off the tree to make somebody's lives much brighter this Christmas. Those gifts were due back today, so if you happen to forget to bring your gifts, see Denise, myself, or Morgan after church. Also in the bulletin, there's some information about other needs Beaufort Christian Ministry needs. Thank you.
I'm Lori Brownson with the Fire Youth Group, and we had a really fun Christmas party yesterday and baked a lot of cookies. And today we'll be delivering them to some of our elderly who are shut in, and even some who get out and about. And if you are a deacon, I think you got a message to please hang out after the service to assist with the cookie deliveries with the youth. Thank you.
Finally, this morning, just a reminder, you should have gotten a letter last week for stewardship. Stewardship is next Sunday, where we're going to be giving our gifts to the King for Christmas. If for some reason you are going to be away for Christmas, a reminder that you can put your pledge card in the box this morning if you need to. And if you've already put your pledge card in the box, thank you so much for that. Also, just a reminder, we have some new technology this year. In your letter, there's a QR code. You can go on. You can just go to forestchurch.org/donate to give or to make your pledge there. But if you have your letter, you can scan that on your phone with your camera and go to that website to plan your giving for the coming year or to give a one-time donation, whatever it is that you would like to do. But if for some reason you didn't get a pledge card, please let me know and we will make sure that you have one for next Sunday. God has blessed us to be in this place during this Advent season as we prepare for the coming of Jesus Christ, for his birth. Let us begin our worship this morning with our prelude.
Thank you.
on this third Sunday of Advent, we invite the Andrews family to light the Advent candles.
We'll start off with some scripture, Isaiah 35, 1, 2. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. On this third Sunday of Advent, we again light the candle of hope, remembering God's promise to be with us.
We also light the candle of peace as a symbol of our longing for peace in the world, as well as for peace in our lives.
Today we light the candle of joy. The candle is a symbol of joy we experience because of God's presence in our lives and the nearness of the celebration of our Lord's birth.
O Lord our God, we rejoice in the coming of our Savior. Give us joy in our own lives so that we may spread joy around the world, not just at Christmas, but always. Amen.
Please stand as we sing hymn number 147, The First Noel.
Jesus,
In Advent, we prepare for the coming of Christ, full of grace and truth. Trusting in God's unfailing grace, let us tell the truth about ourselves, joining in our prayer of confession. Magnificent God, it is easy to rejoice at the wilderness bursting into bloom and the hungry being filled with good things. We may not want the powerful to be brought down or the rich to be sent away. We know that sometimes we are the powerful, sometimes we are the rich, sometimes we are the ones with privilege, ignoring and harming those you would lift up. Forgive us, humble us, and refocus us, that we may follow your way of life and truth. But do not ignore this one fact, beloved. With the Lord, one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. Friends, believe the good news. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Standing as we sing hymn number 121, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
first reading comes from the book of James, chapter 5, verses 7 through 10. Be patient, therefore, beloved, until the coming of the Lord. The farmer waits for the precious crop from the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and the late rains. You also must be patient. Strengthen your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is near. Beloved, do not grumble against one another, so that you may not be judged. See, the judge is standing at the doors. As an example of suffering and patience, beloved, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. This is the word of God.
Now I'd ask the children to come forward for their special time.
Wow. Oh no. So you guys seem excited today. Yeah? Prodigy.
We got Prodigy. And what's the other thing? Pokemon, right? Mm. Yeah, we talk about that a lot. So,
I did on the Firefly Prodigy.
Yeah, you did. Okay, so I want to talk about a word. We used it in the song just that we just sang. It's the word Emmanuel. Does anybody know what the word Emmanuel means? No? So the word Emmanuel, the scriptures tell us, and then if we spoke Aramaic, we'd know that the word Emmanuel means God with us. God with us. So that's what the scriptures say, that Jesus is, that's one of Jesus' names, is God with us. Is that really hopeful in this season, that Jesus means God with us?
Yes. Yeah.
So where have you seen God with you lately? Anywhere?
Yesterday I went hunting and I was getting up the blinds and I tripped on the stairs, but I caught myself.
Oh yeah, so God protected you in the hunting blind yesterday. Yeah, okay. Anywhere else that you've seen God in this Christmas season? God's been with you?
Maybe protecting my sister.
Protecting your sister? From you, maybe?
Yeah. Okay. Because I was getting her at least half to death.
Yeah, yeah.
But being a zombie.
Yeah. So, anywhere else? Well, so in this season, we remember that Jesus was born, right? That's what the Christmas season is about. And Jesus came here for us, for each of you. Not just for me, not just for Miss Laurie, but for each and every one of you. And God goes with you. Jesus is with you wherever you go. So can you remember that this season, this Christmas, and the rest of your life? Yeah, let's do it. Let's pray that Jesus will be with us every step of the way. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you that you sent your son Jesus in this season, and we ask that he would remain beside us and walk beside us and teach us and show us the way. It's in his name that we pray.
Did you
feel
it?
We did.
Sorry, parents, there's cookies afterwards, too. So. Please turn with me to Matthew chapter 11 as we hear once more from John the Baptist in this Advent season. When John heard in prison what the Messiah was doing, he sent word by his disciples and said to him, "Are you the one who is to come, or are we to wait for another?" Jesus answered them, "Go and tell John what you hear and see. The blind receive their sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have good news brought to them. And blessed is anyone who takes no offense at me." As they went away, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. "What did you go out into the wilderness to look at? A reed shaken by the wind? What then did you go out to see? Someone dressed in soft robes? Look, those who wear soft robes are in royal palaces. What then did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, 'See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you.' Truly, I tell you, among those born of women, no one has arisen greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he." The grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of our Lord endures forever. So now, as an interpretation of the word today, we have the Jefferson Forest High School Advanced Choir with us. And as DaShay comes over and gets ready, let's have a word of prayer as they prepare. Let's pray. Lord, prepare our hearts this morning for your word, as your word is delivered to us through song today. So open our hearts, our minds, our spirits, to feel your presence through the words, through the notes, through the songs that we hear and sing together today. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
DaShay.
To ask if there is some mistake.
Ask if there is some mistake.
The only other sounds the sweep.
Only other sounds the sweep
of easy wind and downy.
To go before I
I think you all agree there is nothing like the beautiful music of such talented youth and beautiful voices. Thank you again. Now I ask you to stand if you're able, as we say what we believe by answering the question, Christians, what do you believe? I believe
in God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried.
He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
The Spirit has brought us to this place not just to praise and give worship, but also to lift up prayers for our world, our community, our nation, our friends. Let us join together in the prayers of the people. I'll give you a moment during that prayer to lift up prayers of your own. So let us pray. Lord God, your Spirit has guided us here to be together, to lift up prayers on behalf of our neighbors, our friends, our family, our community, and our world. Sometimes we don't have the words to pray, and we ask that your Spirit would pray for us and in us and through us. As we have heard today, we come to Christmas with our grown-up Christmas lists, and today our lists are long. We pray for peace in the world and an end to violence. We pray that no one would be hungry anymore, but instead that all might be filled. We pray for an end to oppression, that all might be free, that all might know justice. We pray for an end to sickness and ask for your healing presence and power in people's lives. We pray for an end to gloom and darkness and despair, and pray that you would give your light of hope. We pray for our nation. We pray that we would find justice and mercy, and that you would give us your teaching and your ways. And we come to this place with many on our hearts and our minds today, and we lift them up out loud to you now. Lord, hear our prayers. We also lift up those that are in our hearts today. And we ask that you would set us about your mission. For we know who the Messiah is. We know that he has sent us into the world. We ask that you would send us to show your goodness, your grace, and your truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In gratitude to the grace of God in this season, let us give now of our tithes and offerings. God, we thank you for this
time to worship you and ask that through these gifts, through these tithes and offerings, that you would put us on your mission into the world. Help us to share the good news from the tallest mountaintop to the lowest plain, to share your goodness, your mercy, your everlasting love for us, Emmanuel, that you are with us. And we pray the prayer now that you taught us to pray, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now remain standing as we sing hymn number 134, Joy to the World. Please be seated, because we have a special treat here on your way out. First of all, we have cookies, lots of cookies. So don't leave here today without eating a cookie. And so hang out and fellowship, or five. Take as many cookies as you would like. Also, once again, a special thank you to the Jefferson Forest Advance Choir. So thank you again. Anytime you guys want to sing with us, you have an open invitation. And also, before our postlude, it's not in the bulletin, we have one more bell anthem, whatever we call it, song for you. So as you leave today, go into the world and know that God is with you, Emmanuel. In this season, Jesus Christ goes with you wherever you go. So take him and share him. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.